This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program, or for more details.
So now you can see that I am using the same text. How to use that? So under Merge and Center, if I click on this drop-down box, I can see there are four options available: Merge and Center, Merge Across, Merge Cells, and Unmerge Cells. So what are they? We will be talking about all these one by one. So the first one I will be talking about is Merge Cells. Then we will be talking about these two functions, that is Merge and Center and Merge Across. Okay. Guys, before we move to any of these examples, I really want to show it to you how it really functions, merge, when I apply it on one particular selected region. Okay, so if I have selected this region and if I just go and apply merge cells, now you can see there are number of cells there. Okay, let's take 5 by 3. Okay. And if I apply merge cells, so these cells are merged and this is now only one single cell. So if I start typing anything, so you can see it is getting saved under one single cell. Okay. So this is your merge cells. Okay. So now if I talk about, if I select the same region and if I talk about merge across, so what it is going to do is you can see that it has actually created how many cells? 5 cells instead of creating one cell, which was in the previous example, but now it is creating 5 cells, that is under merge across. Okay. So why do we need this function? So we are going to use this function whenever we do have multiple lines and we really want to save the data under different, or we really want to save the data under one single cell for multiple lines. Okay. How to apply this? I'll just quickly show it to you once we are moving to the example. And then we will be talking about merge and center. If I am selecting the same similar kind of region and if I apply merge and center and start typing anything, you can clearly see the difference under merge cell and merge and center, where the text is getting saved under merge and center exactly in the center of that particular cell. Okay, so these are the three different types. Now we will be quickly moving on to the examples. So merge cells. So what I'm going to do is the text should be contained only in one single cell, the way we did under wrap text. I'll be selecting the region where I really want to merge the cells. So what it is doing is it is going to club different cells and make it into one single cell. Fine. So what I'm going to do is go to merge and center, select the merge cells. Now you can see the text is, this is one particular cell. How I got to know? If I just keep clicking on the right side, I can see it is going to this cell and then moving on to another cell. That is B, C column, and then it comes as R column. Okay. So it has clubbed from C to Q into one single cell. Fine. Now we'll be shifting to this one, merge and center. Again, I'll highlight the selected region. Go and click under merge and center. If I click there, now you can clearly make the difference. It is aligned towards left, but it is aligned in the center. Okay. So the way I just talked to you about wrap text, that you can again apply alignments. If you really want to change the text alignment, again, after applying wrap and merge, you can change the alignments as per the requirement. Okay. So now I have taken, we'll be just quickly moving on to the other example. You can see that the text is contained only in these cells. Okay. If I just move to D column, there is no text. Okay. Can you all see this? I have just quickly moved to these cells and showed it to you. So what I'm going to do is I'll be selecting the region. I need to merge and use merge across. I selected, highlighted these cells. Go to merge across. So what it has done is it has created, instead of 4 by 5 cells, it has created only 4 cells. Can you all see this now? So this is how you can use merge and center. Again, the way I talk to you, if you really want to change the alignments, now you can even apply alignments using one of these 6 options. Okay. Guys, this is one common mistake that a lot of students keep doing it. I have given this case 4 wherein you can see that these are the headers. I can see that division, rep ID, these are headers of my sum data, which I used under alignment. So what happens is if you try to merge and center or, I'll just show it to you how to even wrap the text over here. So what it is going to do is if you have highlighted all these cells and used merge and center, it is going to give you an error. It says the selection contains multiple data values. Merging into one cell will keep the upper left most data only. If you click on OK, the other data has been disappeared and it is merged with the data which was contained only in the first cell. Okay, so these are the common mistakes people do where they apply merge or wrap and they forget that the data is also contained under different cells. So it will just retain the data which is contained in the first very cell. Similarly, if I just apply wrap text under this, it is not going to apply. Okay, so these are the common mistakes that we do while applying merge and wrap. So you need to be careful that merge and wrap will only merge the text which is contained in the first cell and wrap the text which is contained in the one single cell. So what is the difference now? A wrap is going to adjust the height and the width of that particular cell and fit the data under one single cell. Okay. And what is merge going to do is, merge is almost like that, but here we are going to club different cells into one single cell, the way we did under merge and center, merge across and merge cells. So many a times you really want to, you know, you have multiple lines wherein you need to apply merge across or you need to merge the cells. So don't worry. We do have the option as merge across. You can apply that and instead of going cell by cell or rows by rows, you can apply it using merge and across, right?
This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program, or for more details.